Hello, classic crew. So I ended up not doing any of the chores that I said I was gonna do. Yo, peep the shirt. Sorry, guys. I got this like in high school. And listen, I ain't about that consumerist life. This is under consumption. This is hashtag under consumption core. I got this Klondike bar. Klondike bar. Yo, what's Jacksepticeye's dog doing here? Sorry. I'm not a Jacksepticeye circle jerker. I hope you guys know that. Like, I watched him like in high school. Anyway, it's not parasocial. So I'm thinking about like if I know like people, like I know PewDiePie's dogs, Maya and Edward, obviously. I don't know his like new dogs' names. Christine from Simply Nailogical's cat is named like Menchie. Except that guy's dog's name like Klondike and like Fluffball or something like that. I don't know. And I don't know, like, there are probably other YouTubers I watch who have pets that I just don't know. Or just can't name off the top of my head. Okay. So I said I was gonna watch, like, more, like, incel type vids of Daddy Butt Cheeks. Sorry for, okay, if you get, I'll stop calling you Daddy Butt Cheeks. I think it's just really funny. Because I don't know what dbdr stands for. Just a guy sharing his life experiences and story trying to get by. Let's see. We will do what your competition on, okay, wait, no. What's like a really incel-y looking one? The open relationship epidemic. The ridiculousness of modern dating. Hey, I'm modern and I'm dating, so we'll watch this.
All right, today I want to talk about just the sheer ridiculousness of modern day relationships. Because is it worth it? Is it even worth it if you're an average or below average man to date? Even if you can, because that's the whole funny part, you know? Most of these guys would just...
Actually, sorry for eating, guys. I said I was gonna do all these chores and stuff, but I realized it's 11 and I have to wake up at 7 a.m. tomorrow, and I'm like, well, I don't really wanna like go through the trouble of like doing my laundry and like cooking. Cause I bought one of those like little pre-made salads and I was like, oh, I'll make it on a later day. I can just make it for tomorrow, I guess. I did enough today. I went to work, then I went to Target and bought like laundry detergent. Oh, and the only reason why I wanted to do my laundry is cause I bought a new piece of clothing that I wanted to wear, but like I would have to wash it before wearing it, you know. And then I went to play rehearsal, and then I came here. I got back at like 8 o'clock. Oh wait, no. And then I went out again. Then I went out shopping for food after play rehearsal, and I got back home at like 9. And then I've just been like chilling. So really, guys. It's been an eventful day. I don't need to do my laundry, okay? Well, okay, sorry. I'm away. But... a point that I wanted to make in my last video that I totally forgot. It's not really a point, but... you know how I said that his avatar looked like Queso cosplaying Gollum? Queso's overweight... but the thing is, I've seen so many like girls comment like that they want to be Queso's wife because he has an adorable, infectious personality. Like, guys, it's Queso. I'm gonna wager that he's in the bottom 50%. But so many people want to, you know, are attracted to him because he has a really good, funny, infectious. I don't mean to be fucking glazing Queso, but like he's just a funny guy with a good personality. But anyway,
completely sent the wrong way. You know, you ain't going your own way. You were sent your own way. The other funny thing too, you know what I want to talk about? I mean, the first thing obviously is just this open relationship epidemic. You know, the struggler's path. This guy on YouTube named Struggler's Path. He called it the cuckolding. I think that's the most hilarious shit in the world. But it's happening. You know, these guys, they're just sitting back, okay, sweetie, open relationship, sweetie. And they'll just sit back and, yeah, they're cut, pretty much. Now, it's funny when you actually think about, like, how much, like, you just see it everywhere now. Like, I know I almost forgot about this one, but you guys remember? It's happened, like, really recently as well. Will Smith, you guys remember that? This dude, you know, his wife, you know, he's letting his wife cheat on him, whatever, cool. Okay, sweetie, open relationship. And, you know, immediately, you know, and his wife gets made fun of at the Oscars by Chris, Chris Rock. You know, Will Smith just, you know, he has a fucking estrogen spike. Not even a cortisol spike, an estrogen spike. It's all pissed, starts screaming, God, I'm so fucking cringe. But, you know, slaps Chris Rock. Oh my God, how fucking embarrassing. Of course, everyone just clowns on him. Like, oh yeah, your wife, you'll get her back blown up by other guys, huh? Oh my God, dude. It's just over for Will Smith. It's over. I honestly would say that ruined his career. I don't respect him whenever. I mean, you know, one thing too, like, what was I gonna say? Like, if you are in an open relationship, men will not respect you at all. Like, 90% of men aren't gonna respect you at all. And, who else recently? Sneeko, that one blew my absolute fucking mind. And the crazy part about these guys, they're not even like bad looking guys. Like, Sneeko, he's like, what, maybe like the top, I don't know, like 10-20% in height, looks. He's not a bad looking dude, he's got status. And he's fucking.
Sneeko's like bald. I used to like Sneeko when he was like younger and made YouTube videos. Sneeko at 16 was peak. I don't mean to sound like Dr. Disrespect right here. Sneeko's older than me by like several years. It's not creepy. When I was watching him when he was 16, I was like 12. So really, guys, calm down. What is it? Okay, Sneeko's not on the top 10%, you guys. But that's just like my preference. I just don't think I just don't like Sneeko's personality. See, again, if you're a good looking guy but you have a fucking douchebag ass personality, like it's such a turn off, personally. And like status, status, whatever. I mean, like status to a certain degree, but be realistic. I mean, I'm not gonna fucking date like a homeless dude who like is gonna be constantly asking me for money, right? But I'm not expecting to like fucking marry a sugar daddy. Like, I'm not, you know. But anyway, let's continue.
Fucking sitting there. Unless you look this shit up. You know, saying like, oh, you need trauma. I was watching my girl get back, her back blown out. And I was traumatized, but I had to let it happen. And, like,
okay. And also, if you guys want to know my personal thought on an open relationship, I'm not about that life, obviously. Like, I wouldn't. I'm getting chocolate all over my bed. Listen, next time my boyfriend sleeps in. Listen, if you're watching this, my boyfriend, next time you sleep in my bed, it's not poop, it's chocolate from the Klondike bar. I swear to fucking God. I don't even know. This is my fault for eating in bed. But we eat an ice cream and wash the daddy butt cheeks at like midnight before work. My thought on open relationships. Obviously I would never participate in one just because like it's the imagery, bro. It's the imagery. I can't think about my man clapping another woman's cheeks, caressing her body. Oh, I can't picture that shit. It's too painful. But I have friends who are polyamorous. And you guys are, I'm gonna lose so many respect points. But it's like, that's their life and they both agreed to it. And it's like, I don't know, man. You don't really know, like, you don't know the full story between what's going on between two consenting adults in a relationship, you know? You don't know the full story. I mean, I don't know. The thing is, it's just like, maybe you, like, it's not intuitive. Like, sure, open relationships to you probably aren't intuitive because you yourself don't desire to be in one. The same way that liking white chocolate isn't intuitive to me, because that stuff tastes like garbage. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, the Lindt little ball things, those are delicious. But any other form of white chocolate, nah. But some people love it. It's not intuitive to me. I think it's gross. Get out of here, nasty ass white chocolate lovers. But I'm not gonna say like there's a white chocolate lover epidemic, right? Like, it's just like, that's between the person and the white chocolate. The same way an open relationship is between the two people in the open relationship. I'm not gonna get it because I don't desire anything like that. But if it's, again, two consenting adults, I don't see the problem. I don't see the problem. And I guess what this guy's trying to argue is that, like, the guys don't actually consent to it. But, like, you, I don't know, man. Like, you don't know that. But anyway.
I can't, like, dude, how the fuck? I was just sitting there watching it happen. You need trauma. Like, bro, what the fuck? Yo, same thing with Adam 22. That guy's, like, what, 6'3"? Look average looking. Same thing, he's got status, money. He's got no jumper. And I fucking swear to God, this dude, him and his wife are sitting on his couch and they're trying to, I'm not even kidding either, they're trying to pick out a dick for his wife to have sex with. Like, these guys are all lined up. And, like, it's just jaw-dropping shit. And, like, Steve-O said something, like, on Twitter. Or not Steve-O, Adam 22 said something, like, oh, why are you guys calling me a cuck? You know, because, like, you know, I thought watching my wife, you know, I thought it was hot guys. They don't get it. They don't get it. And, like, you know, just, I don't know, it's just, like, embarrassing. Like, I don't know if these guys, like, openly, you know, I mean, you can probably have, like, friends and family, you know, members who are, you know, guys, and they're just, like, you don't even know, like, how bad it could be, you know, but I don't know if they even, like, say anything about it. You know, like, oh, hey, Ron, oh, hey, Jim, oh, I'm a cock, oh, you know, I mean, like, I wouldn't, like, that's, like, the type of shit, like, take to the fucking grave. Like, I don't know if Steve was smoking when he said, yeah, you need trauma, I was sitting there traumatized, and when Adam 22 was smoking, when any of these guys are smoking, you know, to actually come out and say this embarrassing shit, you know, and that's the funny part, you know, like, instinctively, every guy is going to clown on a guy, like, if any man on the world, on the planet.
Wait, didn't Sneeko do, like, an open relationship? Because, like, he, like, was cheating on his girlfriend, so he wanted to, like... I don't remember. I thought he did that shit. Like, he did the Mr. Peanut Butter shit, where, like, he was cheating on his girlfriend, so then he, like, let his girlfriend sleep with other guys. I think, I don't really know. But yeah. I'm not gonna get it ever. Because I'm not interested in having an open relationship, but I'm not going to get, you know, I'm not going to get people who like, what's like a food I don't like? I like a lot of food. I'm trying to have a fat ass. I'm never going to like understand people who like cucumber. I have a biological fear of cucumbers. I just can't eat them. I like pickles though. And if you mask the cucumber with enough sauce and other shit and sushi, it's tolerable. It's tolerable. But, you know, I'm never gonna understand wanting to be in an open relationship. The same way I'm never gonna understand people who love to eat cucumber and put that shit in everything. Cucumber salad, more like poison salad, dude. More like poison salad, okay? So, like, yeah. But I'm not gonna, you know, that's between, I'm sorry, I'm making the same exact point. I'm so sorry. I thought I was gonna make another point, but I totally forgot. But, yeah. I don't know the shit between Sneeko and his girlfriend, but that's between Sneeko and his girlfriend. I'm not gonna get it the same way I'm not gonna get people who love cucumbers.
You say, hey, I'm in an open relationship. I'm like, oh, you're getting clowned on regardless, you know? It's like the same shit. It goes hand in hand with the whole. I remember hearing this shit all the time in school. Like, I took so many sociology and humanities classes, and oh my god. But you would always hear this all the time. No one had an answer, but the answer's like so fucking obvious. But you hear this shit all the time. Like, oh, how come when a man sleeps around, he's considered a champ, but when a woman sleeps around, she's considered a slut. And then they're saying, oh, society did this. It's society that did this, and put this false narrative in everybody's head. But no, I finally do have an answer for it. It's pretty fucking obvious. So, well, you know, women can only have a child once every 9 months, and by the age of 30, 40, the eggs, you know, just slowly are gone. You know, fertility. It's much harder to have, you know, children when you're a female, but when you're a male, you have infinite, you know, sperm. You can reproduce infinitely with multiple women, you know, and, you know, passing your genes on to multiple offspring.
Fertility still drops off in men when they get older. Yeah, Bob Chandler had Chris when he was, like, 50, so... It's not super desirable. I'm so scared to see how Robert De Niro's child's gonna be. He had to shoot, like, this year or something like that. I'm really terrified. Okay, I'll throw this out one day. I swear to God, my room is clean. Yeah, but like women shouldn't be valued. I'm gonna stop you right there in your tracks. Women should be valued whether or not they can bear your children, because like we're past that stage where people can just build rockets. I'm rocket pilling again. I'm sorry. Just build them. You're worth so much more than your reproductive potential. Okay? Fecundity. Fecundity, the real F you should really be worrying about is force velocity of the fucking rockets that y'all are making, okay? Build a motherfucking rocket. Stop worrying about whether or not you're worthy of being bangable. The only bang y'all should be concerned about is proving whether or not the big bang was real. Anyway.
You know, I have multiple offspring. I mean, yeah, good, cool. But it doesn't make sense, like, analogy of, like, birth control, all this stuff. You can't beat nature in biology. People are gonna think it's fucking weird. You know, like, one woman and 100 guys, that's just not natural. That's not how it works. You know, but one guy and 100 women, that works. You know, it's I swear to God, guys, it's, like, actually that simple. That's why, you know, society, you know, that's why that whole, like, whole, you know, they just say that shit all the time in school, that's why. Very simple, you know. And I'm getting on this day and age, I mean, anyway, like, why could...
Bruh, it's, okay. Right, but, like, fucking, when we were, like, cavemen and shit, we also had, like, a primal urge to, like, rape people. So, like, just because it's, like, the natural way doesn't necessarily mean it's, like, correct. Is all I'm saying. So, the whole stereotype of, like, slut-shaming women for doing the same thing that men do, is, like, you know, there's a double standard. And sure, maybe it's, like, based on that, like, biological fact, but, like, biologically, we're trying to do a lot of, like, weird fucking shit and think weird shit and want to, like, you know, biologically, we're, you know, biologically, I want to be naked right now, but that's not right, you know? So it's like, just because it's, like, natural or whatever, again, does not make it right. So, we should, like, actually stop the whole double standard of this. I mean, I don't think people should be, like, sleeping around, like, just for safety reasons, men and women, but yeah.
People can't just have, you know, just one partner forever. I mean, I know there's lots of, like, those girls, like, trad wife guys, like, oh, I want a traditional wife who's not promiscuous and to be with me forever and who has, you know, nice values and morals, and, I mean, well, that's nice, like, with the day and age we live in, that probably ain't gonna happen, man, like, that seriously isn't. Let's talk about something, too, you know, my whole wake-up call of, you know, this shit ain't even fucking worth it, man, this ain't worth it, you know, this whole, because, like, I feel like not, like, you know, this day and age with the internet and, like, everything, bro, like, it just made men, like, so incredibly, like, insecure, not even just all of them, you know, you got the chads, the normies, you know, the oofy-doofy normies, the sub-fives, they're all insecure because, you know, because, I mean, every single woman nowadays, you know, they have a phone, they have tons of orbiters trying to reach out, just constantly blowing up the phone, and, you know, basically what I did, fucking, what, like, 2-3 weeks ago, I was on Corey's Corner, I was on live stream, I called on Discord, he was drinking, I was like, fuck it, you know, he's, like, celebrating 2K subs, so, you know, I started drinking, too, and I was, I still think this is fucking hilarious, but I was gonna call him when I just, right, on stream, but basically, when it happened, he was like, oh, he's like, oh, I'm gonna take a piss, blah, blah. And I did off stream, you know, and I removed the number from my fucking phone, but I have two phones, it's technically an iPod, you know, like, uses an email instead of, like, a phone number, so you still call people, but they have a, you know, an iPhone, but, like, the email will come up instead of the number, because, you know, I deleted, like, a lot of people in my contacts and shit, so, you know, I was gonna call her, and I did, and I called her twice, and I was really drunk, and, like, 10 minutes fucking later, you know, she like, wants to FaceTime me, and I pick up the phone, and I'm talking to her for, like, guys, like, maybe fucking 2 minutes, and that's seriously, like, the only intention I was gonna, like, the only thing, I just wanted to talk to her, see how she was doing, you know, that's pretty much fucking it, but her boyfriend, like, some guy, I think it was her boyfriend, her new boyfriend, because, I mean, you know, this day and age, like, women change boyfriends more than I change under there, and, you know, this dude, you know, he picks up the fucking phone, you know, read my address out, so he put my whole address, and he goes, you know, if you call this number, you know, one more time, you know, within 20 minutes, I'm gonna pull up, and, if I ever catch you out in public, I'm gonna fuck you up. And, yeah, I'm on the phone.
Wait, he called his ex? I wasn't actually paying
Boyfriend, sorry. Boyfriend, I mean, you know, let's take a FaceTime. And, well, right, I did iPhones, it's technically an iPod, you know, happening, he was like, I still think this is fucking hilarious, but I was gonna call my latest, right?
Okay, wait, I need to put this at, like, did he say ex? Sorry.
On various, but I was gonna call my one-itis, right?
Your one what-is? One-itis? What is one-itis? One-itis? Oh. One-itis is an unrealistic romantic obsession with another person. Oh. Shit. You'll get over it. I hope. I hope you do. Dude, actually, that's actually really creepy. Don't do that. Because my ex has a case of one-itis, and he fucking leaked my shit online. He, like, doxed me online, and, like, he's gotten better about it, but, like, on his Twitter, he, like, would just constantly subtweet about me, and it was really creepy, and he would, like, pull up to, like, my school and, like, places that we used to go to and shit, like, and not even subtweet, he would just tweet about me, and it's really fucking weird because, like, I mean, luckily, my boyfriend's, like, more chill about it, and he just, like, was like, oh, like, just ignore him, and, like, he didn't do anything to, like, he didn't go, like, back off from her, bro. He wasn't weird about it or anything like that. But, yeah, man, why do you have your ex's contact? You, like, that's weird. That's really weird. I wouldn't, like, It's really weird. I'm sorry. I'm like, I don't know. I went like 100% no contact on my ex. Although, like yesterday when I went to the gaming cafe, he was stalking my League account and then posted about it on Twitter. So I was like, dude, just like, but that's like the one thing I like, I don't know. There's no way he can call me. I'm surprised that she doesn't. I don't know. I have no idea what the relationship was like. So I like seriously. But like, dude, Daddy Butchies, please don't reach out. I mean, her boyfriend or whatever, like, overreacted by saying all that stuff. But you should not reach out to, like, your past relationships, especially if they're in, like, another relationship. Because that's just really disrespectful to them and the person that they're dating. Because if they don't want to be with you, then you should respect their wishes of just not contacting them. But again, I don't know your guys' relationship. I don't know if it was, like, amicable breakup or whatever. But me and my ex, not amicable. Don't want him in my life. And I'm currently dating someone that I'm very, very happy with. And he just can't get that through his head. And it's just, like, really sad because he's just been very bitter about it. He's been very, very bitter about it. And it's like, well, and he was just very codependent in the entire relationship. And, like, you know, he wanted to, like, marry me and have kids with me and all that shit. And it's like, I don't, like, he was just forcing this sort of, like, narrative onto me that I didn't want. And, like, over time, it was just really shitty because, like, we just grew apart as people. And I didn't want the same stuff that he wanted. And to a degree, he just, like, didn't even like me. Like, I'm being so for real. He just didn't like me. He just liked the version of me in his head. Because he would always, like, shit on my interests. He would always shit on the anime I watched and, like, the music I listened to. He literally told me, he's like, oh, you have a bad taste in music. I'm like, okay, dude. And he would, like, always shit on, like, the TV shows that I wanted to watch with him. He hated all my friends. And he just, like, didn't like who I, like, truly was as a person, and he didn't see me as me, right? He just saw me as, like, the projected, like, wife or whatever he wanted me to be. And it's like, that's not cool. But okay, sorry, I'm ranting, but we'll continue this video. I'm, like, cringing. I can't believe this guy contacted his ex. That's really weird.
On stream, but basically, what I'm having is,
I mean,
like,
I guess it's wrong, physical, but I
did on stream. You know, I removed her number from my phone, but I have two phones. It's technically an iPod, you know, like, uses an email instead of, like, a phone number. So you can still call people, but they have a, you know, an iPhone, but, like, the email will come up instead of the number. Because, you know, I delete, like, a lot of people in my contacts and shit. So, you know, I was gonna call her, and I did, and I called her twice, and I was really drunk. And, like, 10 minutes fucking later, I think, you know, she like, wants to FaceTime me. And I pick up the phone, and I'm talking to her for, like, guys, like, maybe fucking 2 minutes. And then, seriously, like, the only intention I was gonna, like, the only thing I just wanted to talk to her and see how she was doing. You know, that's pretty much fucking it. But her boyfriend, her son guy, I think it was her boyfriend, her new boyfriend, because, I mean, you know, this day and age, like, women change boyfriends more than I change underwear. And, you know, this dude, like, picks up the fucking phone, you know, reads my address out, see, like, my whole address. And he goes, you know, if you call this number, you know, one more time, you know, within 20 minutes, I'm gonna pull up. And, if I ever catch you out in public, I'm gonna fuck you up. And, yeah, I'm on the phone. You know, he's like, I know where you stay. He's like, you don't even wanna know what's gonna happen to you if you call one more, if you call back. And I was thinking, I still have been thinking about it, not recently, but I'm thinking about it, like, what the fuck, is this shit even worth it? Like, men nowadays are so insecure and, like, overprotective over this shit. You know what I mean? It's because of the phones, guys. Like, you look at the average man. He doesn't have, like, just tons of women, like, messaging him 24/7. He doesn't have 99 plus on his, you know, Instagram DMs.
Girl, neither do I. Don't have IG DMs. And the people who do, I just ignore. I'm like, okay. Actually, this is really funny. When I was playing League, this gay man slid into my DMs and was like, oh, because, like, one of my, like, I think my, like, phrase on League is, like, hashtag I'm gay or something like that. And, like, he's like, are you really gay? And I'm like, yeah, hashtag I'm gay. And he said, are you single? And I said, oh, I'm a lesbian. And then he was like, okay, chill, have a good one. And I was like, okay. I was like this random ass dude on League. It's, like, very not obvious that I'm, like, a girl. Like, guys, I'm not like other girls. You can't tell I'm a girl gamer. Okay, but seriously, I main Pantheon and Malphite. You would not be able to tell I'm a girl on League of Legends. don't look at my skin. Don't look at my Seraphine skins. Don't look at my, like, don't ignore the fact that I bought all the Seraphine skins. I didn't buy the, like, $40 one, don't worry. Ignore the fact that I have the Prestige Ocean Song Seraphine. Ignore it! Ignore it. But you can't tell that, you cannot tell that I'm a man on my League account. It's strategic. Strategic. So, yeah, I don't have people sliding in my Instagram DMs. And if I do, the people who slide on my Instagram DMs are, like, bots. So I'm just like, okay, block. What was I gonna say? But yeah, I agree that it's a little insecure to be, like, that overprotective. Oh my god, that this, like, it's, like, flashbanging me to, like, my ex. One time I went to a party with my best friend. Well, he's not, like, really my best friend anymore because, like, we kind of fight a lot and I'm, like, not, like, he's, like, we both, like, it's just drama. We just feed off each other and drama and whatever. But I went to a party with him and, like, another friend. And then, like, my ex just kept messaging me. I'm like, when is this guy gonna leave me alone? It just was really annoying and cumbersome. And I was just like, dude, like, you know where I am. Like, I'm fine. I'm not gonna cheat on you. Like, and then, like, I just got, like, so fed up that I just gave my best friend the phone. And then when I came back home, he called my best friend on my phone and said, if you, like, blah, blah, blah with her, like, if you blah, blah, blah with Aracene one more time, I'm gonna fucking kill you. And it was just, like he was getting violent and shit. Like, that man had anger issues. Okay? So, I don't know. Luckily, I think this story has to do with me. This story has to do with moi. Okay? So, I'm allowed to share this story. But I got, like, groped one time at a rave. And... Well, no one really did anything about it, but after the fact my boyfriend was really mad. So that's the one time my boyfriend's been, like, really mad, I think. So yeah, anyway.
You know, he's not constantly Snapchatting people 24/7, so these dudes, they get, like, so insecure and shit, and they want to fucking fight you all the time. And now I know this was my fault, I wouldn't have done that sober at all, but it made me see the bigger picture, because I've seen it, you know, firsthand with guys. You know, like, especially because I live in the city, like, even at, like, bars and whatever, it doesn't matter, you're approaching. That's why, like, I'm gonna be, like, 100% honest, you know, I'm scared to approach women nowadays. I really am. Now that I shave my head, I don't know if you guys know this, I shave my fucking head. I'm sober, I don't give a fuck. I really, I swear to God, like, I'm at a point, like, I don't care. It's not really, like, none of this is even really worth it, you know. But, you know, so I've seen guys approach, you know, girls, and then, like, their boyfriend will just fucking pop out of nowhere and start, you know, screaming, like, fucking threatening them and shit. Like, don't talk to my girl, bro, you wanna fuck, and I guarantee you, like, most of, like, college fights that break out in these fucking parties are probably from, like, clueless guys approaching women, and they don't know they have boyfriends. You know, and then they get this, what are you talking about, bro? You know, because the chads, they'll fucking fight you. You know, the goofies, they'll just, I've seen this shit too, where they're like, sweet, don't talk to him, please, but I'll just, like, try to, like, take her out of this. It's just insane. It's just fucking insane nowadays, man. You know, it just, it really is fucking insane. But yeah, I was just, like, so embarrassed. I'm like, holy fuck, dude. You know, he was probably, like, listening in to, like, me, like, saying shit. I was just, like, asking her about, like, it's just simple shit. I was talking, like, hey, how you doing, dude? Yeah, what's up, dude? And yeah, the guy just goes, yeah, he said that, he reads out my address, goes, you know, fucking 20 minutes, if you call back one more fucking time, I'm gonna fucking come there. You know, if I ever see you in public, you know, I'm gonna jump you. You know, not worth it. Not fucking worth it. Not even remotely, remotely, remotely.
Yeah, I would not date an insecure guy like that. Because that's just weird. And, like, that's how my ex was. Well, no, not even. Dude, I've been hit on in front of my boyfriends. I've been hit on in front of multiple partners. And they kind of just, like, watched. And I was, like, very uncomfortable. I was, like, can you do something? Like, low-key, I kind of want them to be violent. Well, not violent, but I want them to, like, do something. It's like, the tough thing is, honestly, is that, like, I feel like if I were to say no to a man, he wouldn't respect that. But if my boyfriend said no to a man, he would respect that because I belong to my boyfriend. I'm not my own autonomous person that can just say no because I don't want to be dealing with this stank-ass dude, like, trying to flirt with me, right? I belong to a man, and the man has authority over me, so if he says that I need it, whatever. The thing at the rave, this happened, like, a while ago, is this guy kept talking to me, like, grinding on me. He was, like, a fucking cockroach, like, standing behind me. It was, like, gross. It was so disgusting. And he kept talking to me, and I was like, yeah. He's like, who are you with? And I'm like, are you single? And I'm like, no, I'm not. I have a boyfriend. I pointed to my boyfriend, and then it's like, oh, cool, man. And since my boyfriend didn't like step in and do anything then, he probably thought that I was like lying and just like picked some random dude to choose to be my boyfriend. So yeah, that's an annoying thing, is that like creepy guys won't leave you alone until you declare yourself as another man's property. I should have just said I was a lesbian. It worked on League. It worked playing League.
I'm overly close to dealing with it. You can understand as well, you know, my witness, you know, she's like a little older than me, she's like 24, 25. You know, she's a young white woman, you know, and this is the thing too, like, you know, young white women, you know, that are over like the age of 20, they have the most desired phenotypes. Like, guys just, they just, for some reason, they just get orbited the most, they just do. You know, young white women with blue eyes, they just get orbited constantly, just guys are just constantly, and oh my god, it's not worth it. You know, now people are probably gonna be like, oh no, just, you know, just don't, you know, maybe within your league, bro, just, you know, but still, you know, regardless, every female ever now, because of the internet, has orbiters, you know, some more than others. But just, it's just the way the world is now. And you just gotta be fucking careful when you're like talking to women now, because it's just, you know, your fucking boyfriend's going mad and wanna fight you. And I'm not gonna explain this to a couple of people. You know, you fucking like got girlfriends that are constantly just like, you know, getting hit on and shit. And like,
okay, well, I got news. Well, I don't know, maybe it's because I'm just like in the lower leagues or whatever. But me and all of my like women friends don't have orbiters, because like, yeah, but I don't know. It's not even because we like really act conservatively or like dress conservatively or anything like that. Maybe just me and my friends are all just fucking ugly. I don't fucking know. But we don't have orbiters. I think that's just like, I think that's kind of a misconception. I've only been hit on, like, I've only been like seriously hit on like maybe 3 times in my life. I've been catcalled a lot, but that doesn't really count because it's just like tweakers most of the time. But I've only like been seriously like approached and hit on and asked out in public like 3 times ish, I think. So yeah.
They're like so mad about it, and it's like, I mean, there's nothing you can do, it's just inevitable at this point. You know, I mean, like, oh, this guy's stealing my girl, I'm fighting you, bro, I'm fighting you, bro. You don't pull up and fight you, bro, this guy's stealing my girl, such a cute. Like, dude, just, that's just like wasted energy right there. There's no reason to get fucking mad, dude. You know, it's just absolutely unavoidable and inevitable, and it just seriously is, you know. But, you know, this is like part of the reason, like the fear I have to even talk to women and why I just really don't, it's because, like, you know, you talk to a woman and then her boyfriend will just, you know, randomly appear out of nowhere and start threatening you. Oh, talk to her. It's like, how am I supposed to know in most cases? How am I supposed to actually know? You know, same thing with the internet. And it's not even just that. It's like, you know, it's just like, just modern relationships in general. Like, I'm gonna talk about, like, you know, my whole online dating attempts, you know, on Tinder in a bit, like, maybe in a future video, but, like, you know, I've heard some absurd shit. Like, I was talking to this one girl, you know, back when I was in college years ago. And she was saying, like, yeah, I got a boyfriend, blah, blah, blah. And it turned out, guys, there's some dude from the fucking Netherlands that she never met ever. Like, she never once met. She was, like, e-dating for, like, 4 years or some crazy shit like that. Never met the fucking guy. And here I was thinking, oh, since I'm in, you know, face-to-face in person, thinking I have a shot. And she's like, you know, I wouldn't cheat on him. He's everything to me. I just don't care anymore. Like, you just sit back and just, you know, just laugh at all this shit. Because it's just all absurd now. The internet, it's just all absurd. But, yeah, man, it's just not worth it, man. It's just, you know, so, yeah, after that incident, and I really want to talk about it, too. I'll mention it again, maybe in, like, a little bit, like, in a future video. I want to talk about just, like, the absolute clown state of drinking culture. And it's just, none of this is worth it, you know. None of this is worth it anymore, you know. I just gonna sound like, you know, some big telco, because I understand fully, I was sent my own way. Beyond sent my own way. I ain't going my own way, I was sent my own way, you know. And, I don't know, I just wanna focus on a career, you know. DoorDash approved me finally, so I'm gonna start doing that soon. I might start living in my car. You know, there's a couple things, you know, that are going on right now, you know, that, it's not the worst thing in the world, but my priorities are obviously ass backwards, you know. But, like, just modern, you know, just modern dating and all that, it's just not worth it for men like me, you know. I'm ugly as fuck. I've been laughed at. That's not even, I want to say publicly as well. Like, drunk women on the street, man, like, you know, in the city, they are ruthless. You know, they will laugh in your face and just, like, oh my god, it's bad, man. That's another thing, like, I can't wait to get out of here because of that. It's just, like, so brutal. I don't even get mad at it. It's just, like, it's just extremely brutal. You know what I mean? But what else do I want to talk about? What else is kind of ridiculous now? I mean, that the situation shifts. Yeah, kind of same shifts. I've seen those blown up all the time, actually.
Okay. Situation shifts. There's no such thing as a situation. That's just a bad relationship. Because if you and someone else are seeing each other and not seeing other people but don't want to officially claim it as a relationship, then y'all are just too scared and it's not a good relationship. And either continue dating other people and not officially date this person, or just fucking bite the bullet, or just say, hey, if you're not ready to be in this committed thing with me, I'm looking for that and I don't want to be in a situationship. I know you're not going to change. I know you're not gonna change, you know. So yeah.
Fucking thing. Someone said that recently. the end of IRL, I can't remember who. No, maybe I was in like a store or something. I can't remember exactly at the moment. But I overheard some like girl talk about ominous. I'm in a really heavy situationship right now. Like, what the fuck is that? A situationship. Okay, well, which orbiter do I want to pick out of my DMs? You know? But you know, you always notice like when a guy, like when a movie dude, like
okay. Myself. Daddy butt cheeks, let me teach you what a situationship is. It's when like it's just two people that like hook up, go on dates, whatever. And they're like seeing each other and like not really seeing other people, but they don't officially want to be girlfriend boyfriend or girlfriend girlfriend boyfriend boyfriend. We're gender inclusive. What was I gonna say? So yeah, it's situationships is mainly just like one person wanting a relationship and the other person like leading the other one on, or two people too afraid to actually commit to something, or like something along those lines. It's not a girl with like a bunch of orbiters, which by the way is not a real word. I don't know, maybe it's just because I'm like kind of like a like I am just a homely little Asian girl with like a flat chest, but like I don't have orbiters. No one's in my Instagram DMs. No one's in my friends' Instagram DMs. So, I don't know.
Elf, we're just ugly as fuck, who, like, I've never had a girlfriend, you know, you're getting older and shit, like, what day is today? So, I think in a few days I'll be exactly, yeah, July 1st, I'll be exactly, 23 and a half. Crazy shit, man. But, like, I feel like guys like myself, you know, you hype up, like, relationships, like, so fucking bad, you know, so you've never, like, experienced it before. And then, you know, since you're like goofy doofy, like for whatever reason it is, like you kind of like have it in the back of your head, like, oh, am I being used for XYZ? You're just always insecure about everything, you know, just constantly. You know, because you're yourself aware enough to know, like, you know, I'm ugly as fuck, why is this woman in a relationship with me? Even if you are, you know, on the same like looks level, there's still like insecurity you have in the back of your head. And I feel like, because I mean, I've seen it, you know, these guys like cheated on or broken up with or whatever it is, like, they just like, they lose it. Like, they fall into like these like horrible depressions. They just get fucked so bad. Like, there's these two kids I used to hang out with, like, not like a few months ago, but like their brains just fucking snapped. Like, they got cheated on. And their brains just fucking snapped, and I'm just looking at them, and I'm like, they're just so fucking clueless. You know, like, they're just like, so, just like the way they talk about life. It's just like this extreme, like, just fucking cluelessness, like a deer in headlights. Like, you're just trying to explain, like, oh, you know, I gave her everything, bro, and, like, she still cheated on me. Like, I don't get why, it's not fair.
Guys, I have a friend like this named Kyle. What do I tell him? What do I tell him? He always messages me on Instagram. He goes, did you find me a girlfriend yet? I'm like, bro. He's going to the military, man. Which, by the way, this is a whole other shit. I can't go into this rant, but I'm so anti-military. Just watch the Boy video about it. Boy is the I Did A Thing second channel. Just watch that video, okay? Sorry, I like don't feel like explaining that shit.
Sure, and I just feel so bad for these guys. I mean, fuck, man, shit, it's just like so brutal, you know? And they just can't handle the breakups. You know, they went so long in their life without a relationship, without anything, that like they just can't handle the breakup or the cheating or whatever. And they're just like starched, like they're just like laying in bed, like, fuck, like, kick my ass, fuck. Just like mental breakdown shit, and they end up in the hospital. And that's like the fucking crazy part. Like, the guys like end up in the hospital and shit, like, usually what causes it, like, you guys see this shit on like the news all the time, like, you know, Mr. Oofy Goofy, like, his wife, you know, cheats on him and like snaps and like does some crazy shit, you know, because these guys are just fucking clueless. Like, they just don't get it, you know, like, oh, I put all my money and everything into this relationship, what happened? Well, I'm raising the kids that are on my own, what happened? Why didn't she leave me? That reminds me of like, my mom's like old boyfriend, like, he's been fucking jealous, he snapped after they broke up, and it's just like. Oh, it's just so not worth it anymore, man. Like, I swear to God, I've been doing like some heavy thinking, like, bro, I should like stop, you know. Maybe I can never begin anyway, you know. I really don't talk to women at all, so it's, I mean, I feel like I'm fucking building, what am I talking about? Yeah, just doesn't even matter, you know. I haven't like talked to a woman besides, you know, that, you know, my one-itis, like, even that shit's like barely. I think like, that one girl I talked to for like 2 days, that one like girl at the strip club before she blocked me, and that's the fucking hilarious thing, you know. She blocked me because I confronted her about it like another day. She said, oh, my, I got a boyfriend and he made me block you. I don't know if that's BS or not, but I wouldn't doubt it wasn't. But it's just not worth it, man. Yeah, you know, I guess that's pretty much it.
Why is this man going to strip clubs? What the fuck? What the heck? Bob, while you were jorking it out of strip club, I was reading Anna Karenina. While you was at the strip club jorking it, I need to read more Anna Karenina. It's like rough, guys. I don't know. I'll pick it up again. The chapters are so short. I could literally read it. Well, I want to go to bed right now, but okay. Well. It was a little incel-y. It was a little incel-y, but it wasn't like. Horrible. But the thing is, like, a lot of YouTubers or whatever, like. in this sphere. They're very, like, dehumanizing about the way that they talk about other people who live, like, different lives than them. And, like, that's the issue, is that there's so much polarization between different groups of people, and it just leads to people dehumanizing each other. And that's, like, not cool. Because you're human no matter what. You're, like, everyone's, like, equal. Unfortunately, like, so many factors play into our lives that, like, we aren't equal. But inherently, we should be, right? Because we're all human. But it's just, like, sorry for this, like, if this is, like, corny ass shit. But, like, it's what I, like, I don't know, man. It just makes you sad that people think this way about me. And yes, I'm very privileged to lead a very optimistic life. But I can see how you can get sucked into this kind of stuff and then, like, go further and further down the pipeline, polarize yourself more and more from people different from you, dehumanize them more, and just think that the world is one way, this one extreme, when in reality there's so much nuance to everything, right? There's so much nuance to everything and everyone, because everyone leads their own life. Because it is very easy to, like, categorize people into different subcategories and classes, whatever you want to call it. And, you know, because it's just taking the path of least resistance. You can't not physically, like, use all your brain power to look at every single person in the street and be like, wow, this person is XYZ and XYZ. They might have similar traits to this and that, but, like, they're their own person and they have their own interests. And you don't think about that, obviously, because that just, like, would be insane and would take up too much brain power, right? But, like, it's a dangerous road to do this and be like, oh, the world is this way, when, like, sure, like, shitty stuff like this happens. What? Oh, this is my hair. I thought I had, like, a chocolate thing on my arm. Shitty stuff like this happens, right? That's just life. But it's, there's nuance in it. There's, like, it's just not black and white. And it's, like, I don't know. Should I react to more daddy butt cheeks? I don't know. This would make me feel so sad, dude. But, like, like, I can understand why he, like, feels this way. Because, like, sure, I don't agree, but his, like, feelings aren't invalid, because I'm sure he's experienced things and witnessed things and gone through a life that would make him believe in stuff like this. The same way I have gone through a life, albeit a very privileged one, the same way that I have gone through a life to make me feel XYZ about XYZ. Like, I have a tough time trusting guys because I was put through, like, a really shitty relationship for, like, 2 years. So, like, you know, I'm gonna feel this way about men because the most, like, the longest experience I've had with a man has been pretty bad, right? And I'm sure he's gonna feel this way about relationships because maybe he doesn't, you know. But it's all just a matter of perspective, and it's like, if you put yourself in, like, this echo chamber and only surround yourself with the same perspectives as you, it's just like, you know, I don't know. You can't delude yourself. Well, I don't know if it's, like, deluding or whatever. That's kind of a mean word to say, but, like, I'm stuttering. Why am I stuttering so much? Ew. You can't delude yourself into thinking this way. Because everyone has a different experience, and, you know, it's not all bad. And I'm sure this guy has, like, experienced a life that's pretty bad, which is why he feels this way. And, you know, I don't really even know what to tell him, because, like, his most recent video, he's like, oh, I'm gonna be living in a car, and it's like, bro, He's living. First of all, his first move should just be move out of New York City, because that's like the most awful place to live, in my opinion. I feel like if you move like just to the countryside, like people, if you move to the countryside and talk to people who aren't terminally online, then I feel like you'll be set. But that's just, that's my advice to this, to Daddy Butt Cheeks. So yeah, this has been Read with Aristide. I swear, y'all, I will be picking up Anna Karenina at some point. At some point, I'll be picking the book up back again. At some point. Because it's a good book. It's very beautifully written. I love Russian literature. I love it. I love Russian literature. I love it so much. So yeah, I don't know. That's my thoughts. So, let me know if I should watch more Daddy Butt Cheeks. Sorry. I don't know what to call him. DBDR. Dude, what does it stand for? What does it stand for? Well, wait, let me look at his other links. Saint DBDR Music. Oh! Oh, he makes music. This is like his side channel. Why does he got why do you have Kakegurui clips in the thumbnail? What is this? Kakegurui in the thumbnail in 2024 is crazy, bro. It's crazy. That is some 2020 shit. This guy needs to work on his thumbnails. That's all I have to say. Wait, what's it? Oh, so he has a Spotify? Saint DB. Dude, what does DBDR stand for, you guys? Let's listen to his music. I'm not listening to this. What is this thumbnail? What is this, a freaking album cover? Thank you, but I will stick to my electro swing music. I don't listen to electro swing. What? Look at my Spotify top artist. Spotify. Iceberg. I think the Spotify Iceberg is like, okay, it's Icebergified. So, okay. So my Spotify. My Spotify Iceberg is as follows. On the top, we have Lofi White Noise Radiance. Who the f- I don't. Stop! White Noise Radiance is the. Because I used to watch, like, or listen to, like, the rain sounds for sleep Spotify song. Okay, so White Noise Radiance. White Noise Radiance. Okay, White Noise Radiance could be a good band name too. But yeah, I used to listen to, like, rain sounds for sleep because I, like, it's like. I need fucking ambient sound. I can't sleep in silence. It's like. The horrors, dude. So Lofi, White Noise Radiance, TV Girl, Biba Doobie, Deftones, Weezer. Weezer is below TV Girl, which is weird. Weezer's more whatever. Andrew Underberg. I can't believe that's on there. It's the guy who made the Has-Been Hotel ass shit. Mindless Self-Indulgence, MF Doom, Red Velvet. Then at the bottom. Not the bottom, but like the layer below that. We have Chet Baker, Rocco, Mick Gordon, Hers, Potsu. Tier below that. Wayne Newton, Rav, Glass Beach, The Dead Milkman, Negative XP. The tier below that, we got Jezebel Gaburgably, Billy Cobb, Willie Rodriguez Was Taken, Choking Victim, Rhett and Link. There's so much incel core on this. Tier below that, Penguin Band, the excerpts, Willie Rodriguez was taken archive, and then tier below that, the Juliet Dagger and Ye Ming and the Rumors. There, on this fucking iceberg, there's like, there's too much incel core. Wait, Spotify stats. I love looking at Spotify statistics. Okay. Login with Spotify. Login with Spotify. So, the last 12 months, my top tracks have been Lost in Translation by Willie Rodriguez Taken, because it's a good song. It's, oh, I've got a little hairpin. It's a good song. Kokomo In by Japanese Breakfast. Words by F.R. David. Vampira by Willie Rodriguez was taken. Kiss Me, some Japanese song. Heartbreaks and Hand Jars, Willie Rodriguez was taken. Pasleep. I Hate White Girls by Creepy Brick. Blue Song by Biba Doobie. Not Like the Other Girls. There's too much fucking incel core on this shit. I don't understand why I don't listen to that much shit. I guess I just had a phase where I listened to a lot of it, but whatever. Okay. Top artists. Last 12 months, Willie Rodriguez was taken, and they're fucking broken up. Can you believe it? Okay, Willie Rodriguez was taken, Biba Doobie, Deftones, Jezebella Gaberkeley, Laffy TV Girl, Weezer, White Noise Radiance. You guys. Radiohead. Why is Radio? I don't listen to Radiohead. Okay, what is this corny-ass thumbnail that Iron Maiden has as their thing? What is this corny-ass Iron Maiden? Why'd you hire an AI artist to do your thumbnails? Iron Maiden, I need to talk to you. Iron Maiden, what's going on? Talk to me, girl. Okay. More Spotify. Spotify Pie. We're gonna do some Spotify Pie. Oh wait, what the fuck? Where did it go? Spotify Pie. Okay, let me just get off of this. Okay. Spotify stats. Spotify Pie. So, we'll do Spotify Bubble. George Harrison, Spotify Pie. My Spotify Pie is POV Indie, Soft Rock, E-Punk, Furry. It's all that has been hotel music I'm listening to, I'm telling you. K-pop girl group, album rock, classic rock, folk rock, Mellow Gold. And we got Willie Rodriguez is taken, Red Velvet, George Harrison, Johnny, TV Girl, Keanu Bicol, Rav, Japanese Breakfast, Gilbert O'Sullivan, and Miracle Musical. I refuse to believe that this is my all-time stats. I think it's just from the year. Cause like, yeah. But, well, let's start to receiptify. I can't fucking spell. Let's do my receiptify. Brat edition? Guys, y'all need to stop it. Okay. So my receiptify for last month is Hey Leonardo, She Likes Me For Me, which is this corny ass song. It's like, I'm gonna sing it out loud for you guys. Can I do karaoke? It's a good song. I'm singing this. She don't care. Oh shit. It's good. Wait. Oh my god, they sing right away. Okay. She don't care about my car. She don't care about my money. And that's real good because I don't got a lot to spend. But if I did, I wouldn't mean nothing. She likes me for me. Not because I look like. Oh, it's had two times a beat. I was like, why is this. Like, okay, there we go. Sorry. She don't care about my car. She don't care about my money.
And that's real good, cause I don't got a lot to spend. But if I did, it wouldn't mean nothing. She likes me for me. Not because I look like Tyson Bedford with the charm of Robert Redford oozing out my ear. For what she sees are my faults and indecisions, my insecure condition, and tears upon the pillow that I shed. She don't care about my big screen or my collection of DVDs. Things like that just never matter much to her. Plus she don't watch too much TV. And she don't care that I can fly her to places she ain't ever been. But if she really wants to go, I think deep down she knows that all she has to say is when. She likes me for me. Not because I hang with Leonardo or that guy who played in Fargo. I think his name is Steve. She's the one for me. And I can't just live without her. My arms belong around her. And I'm so glad I found her once again. And I'm so glad I found her once again. And I'm so glad I found her once again. Gazing at the ceiling. Oh, wait, shit. Gazing at the ceiling as we entertain our feelings in the dark. The things that we're afraid of are gonna show us what we're made of in the end.
Oh, instrumental break, sorry.
She likes me for me, not because I sing like Pavarotti, or because I'm such a hottie. Ah, I like her for her, not because she's fat like Cindy Crawford. She has got so much to offer. Why does she waste all her time with me? There must be something there that I don't see. She likes me for me. Not because I'm tough like Dirty Harry, make her laugh just like Jim Carrey, unlike the cable guy. But what she sees is that I can't live without her, and I'm so glad I found her once again. Found her once again, once again. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I'm so sorry, you guys, but it's a good song. You should listen to it on your own time. I did not do it justice, but, and I guess it's not, I can't sing it, but anyway. So Recitify, Hey Leonardo, Pasillo by Sunkissed. It's such a dreamy song. Listen to Pasillo. It gets me emotional. I was slow dancing with my boyfriend to that song. I'm emotional, bro. Okay, Cosmic by Red Velvet. Goated ass album. Listen to the Red Velvet EP. Best of Me by Keanu Bicol. Like, pretty like mid. 360. When you in the mirror, why are you looking at me? Good song. What's in a Kiss by Gilbert O'Sullivan. It goes, what's in a kiss? Is it more than just temporary bliss? Your obedient servant. Because I have to sing that song on stage. Painted Lady, Late Night Drive Home. Sunflower, Red Velvet, Right Now, New Jeans. Let's do Last Year. Last Year. Okay, oh wait, never mind. Last Year, we already know this one. Last 6 months is Pasillo, Sunkissed, I Was Made For You by Rivers Cuomo. Velvet Ring by Big Thief. It's a good song. It's like very much like Juno vibes. Good song. Want You Bad from the Taxi Driver soundtrack. Hey Leonardo, Grapes by James Marriott. Backflip I'm singing backflip. Watch me backflip. Watch me backflip. Let me work my magic. Let me work my magic. Watch me backflip. Watch me backflip. Let me work my magic. Let me. If you only knew what the future holds. Wait, I don't even know the lyrics. We still got a whole lot left to learn. If you only knew. Okay, anyway. Nothing matters but you. Alchemy. Yes, I listen to funk, but whatever. And I started a joke by the Bee Gees because I watched Baby Reindeer. Okay, now kill me. So, sorry that I had to go on a whole ass tangent about my own music taste. It's because he posted the link of the Spotify, okay? I'm a slut for Spotify statistics. Show me them bar graphs. Show me them pie charts. I am a slut for them pie charts and bar graphs. I already know what my favorite artist is on Spotify, but tell me again, Spotify statistics. Save me Spotify statistics, okay? Just tell me again what my favorite artist is. I need to be reminded how unique my music taste is. Tell me again. Thanks. Okay, anyway, yeah, see you guys.